What I really like about the study is a couple of things. Number one, the simplicity of the study itself. Number two, the substance used in regard to the study, easily, readily available, and as far as I know, has an incredible margin of safety. Number three, the outcome was significant. So here you have a study where individuals drank a certain amount of cocoa. I utilize the word cocoa as opposed to cacao because that's the word they use in the study here itself, over a 6-month period of time, which yielded quite a significant benefit. And now we're about to review right this second, so let's get right into it as follows. Cocoa could bring sweet relief to walking pain for people with peripheral artery disease. Consumption of cocoa may improve walking performance for patients with peripheral artery disease, according to the results of a small preliminary phase 2 research trial published today in the American Heart Association's journal, Circulation Research. So what the researchers are trying to emphasize here by saying phase 2 is they'd like to see a larger study done in order to validate the findings in regard or reference to this particular outcome of cocoa consumption. To proceed, in a small study of 44 peripheral artery disease patients over age 60, those who drank a beverage containing flavanol-rich cocoa 3 times a day for 6 months were able to walk up to 42.6 meters further in a 6-minute walking test. Now, we're going to proceed ahead a little bit in a few seconds, but that 42.6 minutes further was not in comparison to the placebo group. That was the baseline. So after drinking cocoa for 3 times a day over 6 months, they were able to walk 42.6 meters further on their own. To proceed, those who drank the flavanol-rich cocoa also had improved blood flow to their calves and some improved muscle function compared to the placebo group. Now I want to skip ahead so you get a better understanding of what these results mean. Researchers found that the patients who consumed cocoa showed significant improvement with the walking an average of almost 43 meters further in the 6-minute walking test compared to their baseline results during the test performed at 2.5 hours after the final study beverage. The benefit was so significant over the placebo group, it almost seemed unethical not to have the placebo group drinking the cocoa, but to proceed. Researchers also found increased mitochondrial activity, increased capillary density, and other improvements to the muscle health in those who consume the cocoa. Now you see what I mean in regard to the placebo group. Patients who drank the placebo beverage had a decline of 24.2 meters in the walking distance at 2.5 hours. So after 6 months, they got worse, while the cocoa drinking group became better. After the final study beverage compared to the baseline results, this is consistent with other studies in which people with peripheral artery disease without treatment have declines in their 6-minute walk distance over time. So the cocoa consuming group not only did not decline, they improved as opposed to the placebo group. Researchers hypothesize that the epicatechin, a major flavonoid component of cocoa, may increase mitochondrial activity and muscle health in the calves of patients with lower extremity peripheral artery disease, potentially improving patient walking ability. Epicatechins and flavonoids also have the potential to improve blood flow. All right, here's the consumption amount. Now keep in mind, we're not looking at volume as far as liquid itself. We'll only look at basically at the cocoa being added to anything and drank 3 times a day. So it's 15 grams of cocoa and 75 milligrams of epicatechin. They did not mention any brand names. They just say commercially available. 3 times a day for 6 months. The cocoa used in the study, to reiterate, is commonly available, natural, unsweetened. Let's keep that in mind. Cocoa powder, which is rich in the flavanol epicatechin. To conclude, patients with PAD have difficulty walking that is as bad as people with advanced heart failure. Leg muscles don't get enough blood supply in PAD, leading to injury. And in this study, cocoa appeared to be protecting the muscle and improving metabolism. Quote, we know that exercise therapy helps people with PAD walk farther. And in this early study suggests that cocoa may turn out to be a new way to treat people with PAD. We will need larger studies, again quoting, to confirm whether cocoa is an effective treatment for PAD, but maybe someday, if the research supports it, we may be able to write a prescription for chocolate, I should use the word cocoa here, but I'm only quoting, for our patients with PAD. That is an amazingly simple and possibly very enjoyable therapy for individuals, especially if people are slightly immobile or can't move. Can you imagine that? Your doctor saying, hey, I'm going to write a prescription for drinking natural unsweetened cocoa 3 times a day so we can get some circulation to those limbs. Now keep in mind, this is a walking test. I don't want to have publisher bias, but you can see where you can go with epicatechin, flavanol, rich cocoa, yielding tremendous benefit, if even in addition to an exercise and physical rehabilitation program. Again, this is Ralph Church Channel signing off once again. The DOI citation link will be there. It's an abstract. It's not a full study. There's some good supplementary material there that you can have access to. But otherwise, thank you very much for listening. Look forward to see you all once again in the next 7 days. And catch you all later on. Gratitude. Catch you next time. Bye. See you then.